just south of the international border between the United States and Mexico, and further south of Mexicali, there is a large dark rock formation which notably stands out in the desert landscape. There, what is known as Cerro Prieto rises as much as 200 meters or 656 feet above the surrounding terrain. And, as you might guess from its central several hundred meter wide and more than 100 foot deep crater, Cerro Prieto is indeed a volcano. But, when did this volcano form, what type of volcano is it, and does it pose any future hazards? But first, I want to note something other than this volcano's apparent isolation compared to other young regional volcanic rocks that makes it economically important. You see, it is difficult for me to truly determine whether the Cerro Prieto volcano is dormant or extinct. While this volcano has not erupted for more than 50,000 years, there is reportedly cooling magma of an undetermined age at 5 kilometers or 3.1 miles depth to its east that powers a network of geothermal power plants. These plants have a capacity of 820 megawatts, or enough to power at least 164,000 homes. This stationary magma body could simply be inactive and just have been cooling for a lengthy period of time, or it could represent an intrusive body younger than the Cerro Prieto surface volcanic rocks. Because of this, I am going to preliminarily only assign the Cerro Prieto volcano as dormant, as while unconfirmed, there could be a chance for future magmatic intrusions to happen within a 10-kilometer radius of Cerro Prieto's summit. But let's zoom back in. At first glance, Cerro Prieto's coloration might make it appear basaltic. After all, it has a darker color which looks vaguely similar to California's 79,000-year-old Amboy crater cinder cone. However, in the Sonoran Desert, a thin black coating known as desert varnish commonly coats exposed rock units, so this is actually what you are seeing. Cerro Prieto, in actuality, is a lava dome complex volcano representing a series of 5 high silica dacite lava domes and its associated weathered outlying fragments which are low prominence and fairly jagged. Another reason I mention Amboy Crater is that the entire Cerro Prieto volcano essentially formed at the same time. More specifically, Cerro Prieto formed via a series of between 2 and 5 closely spaced explosive eruptions between 82,000 and 78,000 years ago. The reason why the Cerro Prieto volcano exists relates to a combination of faulting and a very close by tectonic plate boundary. At this boundary, the North American plate to the east is sliding southwards, while the Pacific plate to the west is sliding northwards. However, this labeled zone serves as a pull-apart basin related to the motion of these two tectonic plates, allowing for occasional batches of magma to rise into the crust, interact and mix with ancient solidified granitic intrusions, and then erupt as more viscous lava varieties. The first eruption at Cerro Prieto occurred 82,000 years ago when a volume of viscous magma rose towards the surface, broke through overlying rock, and generated a series of explosions. Rugged, slow-moving lava then expanded outwards in all directions, slowly building a growing lava dome. Throughout the time span of what was likely many months, 100 million cubic meters of molten rock combined to continue growing this lava dome. During this time span, numerous partial collapses of this dacite lava dome occurred, releasing pyroclastic flows which swept over the largely barren landscape in Merapi-type Vulcanian eruptions. Then, towards the end of the eruption, pressure built up underneath the new lava dome summit until it was explosively released, creating a towering eruption column and carving out a more than 1,000-foot-wide crater. What followed was likely a pause of several thousand years until 78,000 years ago, another cluster of lava dome forming eruptions began, this time on the south-southwest flank of the existing edifice. 4 lava domes were constructed, which also created viscous lava lobes that flowed up to half a kilometer distant. In many ways, Cerro Prieto is quite similar to California's Sultan Butte's volcano, just not active and notably older than its California counterpart. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's supporters on Patreon and our YouTube members.